Overnight line movers, Teddy. SportsbookReview.com, the best place on the internet to check. Check out SBROdds.com. Also, give us a follow at SBRSportsPicks on Twitter. Take a look at the first game, Teddy. Bucks Heat total drops a little bit lower on Friday. Offshore markets opened up around 221, now sitting at 219.5. Bucks Heat tangle tonight, minus 5, 219.5. Moneyline split 190 plus 171.
Yeah, we're showing some respect. The market's showing some respect for the Heat's defense. They just absolutely shut down the Pistons. And in fact, you know, you talk about the bad for an NFL NBA offense when teams score 8 points or less in a quarter. It's happened four times this season. And three of those quarters have been Miami Heat playing defense. So certainly a little bit of respect for the Heat defense and what they did to Detroit the other night. And it's also worth noting, five of the last six meetings have stayed way under the total. One did go over. But there was at least one of the two teams that didn't reach 90 points in all five of those games that stayed under. So I'm not shocked we've seen at least a little bit of under money for Heat and Bucks in the overnight slash early morning hours here in Vegas and around the country.
Big move, Teddy, in the Lakers game. Lakers total coming down in their back-to-back outing tonight. Total opens up around 221 offshore and drops to 216. Now sitting, if we take a look around that 216.5, 217 level. Lakers Pistons minus 11 tonight. Big money line split. Plus 588, minus 850. Another loss from the Lakers last night. Continue to move down a little bit south out of Toronto down to Detroit. Doesn't look good for those Lakers tonight. And maybe signaling some injuries or maybe somebody getting some rest tonight, Teddy, on a back-to-back.
Well, I think this total has everything to do with the Pistons. You say it's the Lakers game. No, this is the total move is about the Pistons game. That's Reggie Jackson, the Pistons starting point guard, who's been instrumental in their run since the All-Star break, where Detroit's placed a pretty good ball and moved up in the playoff picture. Jackson is banged up. He has an ankle injury. He's very questionable tonight. The Pistons, without Jackson at 100%, were hopeless on offense the other night in Miami. They, in fact, back-to-back games, where Detroit has been held under 75 points, which doesn't happen in the NBA in 2019. So the market's looking at Jackson's injury, looking at Detroit's offensive struggles, and saying, yeah, we can bet this one Laker game under the total. Certainly there hasn't been consistent and significant line moves for the Lakers under the total at any point this season. So in my mind, this move's about Detroit and their current offensive woes and their point guard injury.